Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Welcome to module 2 of this RoboDK professional training. In this module, my goal is to show you how to create a RoboDK station from scratch using a robot from our library and custom 3D models you created specifically for your project. Let's jump right into it. This is the station we will build throughout the module. It has one robot, one laser cutting head, a custom table, custom part, and if we run here the program, it will cut around the part. So we're kind of mimicking a metal sheet cutting application here. So this will be the end result. As I said, here we have a robot. This robot comes from our online library. I'm going to show you how to reach it and how to load robot from it. It has, apart from that, three custom 3D models that were imported. So generally speaking, any 3D models that you have, if they are in either STEP, STL, or IGES format, can be loaded in RoboDK and used as a custom 3D model. So I will show you how to do that. But before, we will have kind of an intermediary step where we will create this station here. So same robot, same part, but with a table and a tool that are already part of our online library. So it's kind of a little shortcut we will take at the beginning to show you that you can easily create quick simulation using tools and objects that are provided through our online library, but that you can also, at the end of the day, bring your own 3D model to complete your station. Here, while we're at it, I want to show you a little something. So you saw that I jumped from one station to the other. So here in our station tree, we can have multiple stations open inside RoboDK, in fact. And to jump from one to the other, you simply have to double click on the station folder on top here. So if you double click here, it will jump to this final station. If you double click on new station 2, it will open this one up. So you can always kind of expand another station, even if it's not opened, but you won't be able to interact with the content of it. You need to really double click on it to activate it to jump from one station to the other. This is useful later. We'll see how we can use that for kind of creating some templates for our projects so that we don't necessarily have to start from scratch every single time. I will also here create a new station because the goal here for this module is to start from, like I said, scratch. So I will create a new station. To create a new station, you can go to File and New Station, Control N, which I would generally use. So here, Control and N, create a new station. When you have an empty station just like that, you will see that you always have a small reference frame right in the middle. This is the origin of your station. So this is the 0, 0, 0 of your station from where everything will be calculated from. We often try to match the origin of the station with the base of the robot, as this makes sense, but it's not always the case. By the way, you can hide that little frame here by right-clicking the station folder and selecting here visible station reference. That will hide this one in the middle here, and you can rename that here. Let's say 02 cutting example here. So I pressed F2 to rename, or you can right click and select rename. In fact, you can't select rename from here. You really have to do F2 in this case to rename this one here. Perfect. Just before we end this video here, I want to show you how you can easily or quickly import 3D models that are from your local library. So RoboDK has two types of library. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to use the online library, the one that is kind of up to date with all the robots in it. But you also have a local library with some examples, some robots that are already like local to your computer, some tools. So I want to show you that real quick. So if you click here on the blue folder, it should open in C RoboDK library. So as the name suggests, this is the library I was talking about. If you look at that folder, you'll see a bunch of examples here that you can draw information from. There is a bunch of objects, a bunch of robot. In this case, I generally kind of classify them or filter them by type. So this way I have all the robots, all the objects, a bunch of other stations here, a bunch of tool. We can see here the tool icon with the little gripper that we can pick object from. So let's say I want to pick a robot. Let's go and simply pick a small ABB IRB 120. If I click OK, the robot is imported in my station. So just like that. So exactly the same way as the robot we had in module one, but that was already imported. Perfect. You can do the same with some tools. So if you see this, the little icon of the tool. So here, let's say I can go and take the paint gun tool here. If I click open, this one's a bit too big. It's not a big deal with here. It's just for the example. But it will, as it's a tool, it will be attached automatically to the robot flange, and you can use it as usual to kind of move around the robot, rotation or motions. So that works obviously. And you can do the same with a small object. So let's say here I have object inspection.stp for step. If I click open, it's here. I can create a frame, put that object in the frame here, and simply bring it in front of the robot for us to start creating a program on top of it, and I don't know, paint it in this case. So that's simply kind of what we're about to cover together. So importing objects, importing robot tools, creating custom tools, and so on and so forth. So I hope you'll follow these step-by-steps. They are very useful if you want to be able to create your own station. Watching those will really save you a lot of time in your personal project. So see you in the next video, guys.